So many good things have happened actually in the last few months for you. I mean, you've got a top 30 song now.
Yeah.
How does that feel? I mean, is that when you're doing the show, and we'll get to The Voice. When you were doing the show, did you have dreams like, oh, I'm going to be on the charts or any of that?
Well, I've told a few people this. You know, when you see those movies and those documentaries of, you know, an artist that is now like a big deal, and they tell their story of like, oh yeah, the first song, and we looked at the charts and we were number 161, and then we were 112, and then it was 77, and then number one, you know, and they just show those like little images of that happening. It's crazy, but that's kind of been happening. Like, and to see, you know, to hear those stories of like artists that have really been influential for me, and to see that happening now, you know, thanks to you guys, and thanks to a lot of other stations, you know, in the area, and just by believing in the song, it's just really surreal to be having that happen for me.
I mean, and obviously you've been doing this for a while.
Yeah.
But did you have, is this what you've always wanted? Is it, now that this is all happening, is it as you would have imagined? I know you talked about people looking at the charts and things, but is the machine that you work in the middle of?
Well, to me, it's always been important to stay true to myself and to not get caught up in the whole things that you can get caught up in as an artist that's, you know, especially coming from The Voice, you know, there was so much hype that, you know, you can really sit, you know, your head can get big and you can be up here, and it's really important to, you know, get grounded and really remember where you came from and what you want to, you know, do or be as an artist, what you want to say. And for me, what kind of happened was there was a lot of time that went by for me to kind of sit with this song, and for, you know, DJs and other people hearing the song to kind of just sit with it and be like, well, aside from being from The Voice, we actually like the song. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not about her being on the show, you know, because since now they're on season 4, you know, and it, since then you kind of lose the steam of right. being on a hit show. And so I'm really happy the way this is going. You know, it's people just believing in the song and the message, so.
Have you heard, I know you worked with CeeLo, and you recently did a thing with CeeLo.
Yeah.
The holiday or Christmas show, right, thing,
yeah.
didn't you do? Have you heard from him, or do you talk to him at all? I mean, what does he have to say about what's happening in your life?
Well,
any advice he gave you?
I mean, at first he was just like, you know, stick with it. This is how it happens. And I've heard not only from CeeLo, but, you know, from other artists, you know, Adam Levine and people that actually had to do this organically and not being on a TV show. You know, this is there. All the stories. I did that for a couple years to get my song on the radio. You know, like, this is how it works. You know, don't lose faith. Just keep with it. And now, you know, because of the buzz that's happening with the song and people liking it, you know, CeeLo and I, we're going to be working on a video, you know, after the new year. And
cool.
And to continue to promote it and promote the album and hopefully get another single out, you know, as soon as possible.
All right. So I know what your record sounds like.
Yeah.
But for someone who hasn't bought it yet, and you should buy it, how would you describe your sound to someone that maybe isn't familiar with you, even if they've never even seen the show before?
Well, I think the songs are, you know, there's a lot of power in the songs, vocally, but it's really just a story of my life, you know, from, you know, just, you know, Come Along is a cover song, but it's a song that I chose to sing and begged, you know, Peter Svensson, who wrote the song, for me to be able to cover it, because I felt the message was really necessary right now. You know, people, you know, my peers, just, and not just my peers, everyone in general, to, you know, take a stand and take a chance and believe in themselves. And that's basically the message in that song. And then everything else is basically, you know, my story, you know, in the last few years. And that's why I ended up calling it Vicci, because it's just kind of like a little personal diary, you know, of my life.
Did the record come together? I ask songwriters all the time, you know, they say some of the best songs kind of almost write themselves. Did you labor a lot over a lot of the songs, or did the record come together pretty quickly?
We wrote a lot of songs, and the songs that we actually picked out were the ones that came together quickly, and that was because, it's that special moment that, you know, you just, you reach that, you know, whether it's with another producer or another writer that's in the room. One of the really intimate songs on there, or personal songs, is called Let Go, and it's a song I wrote about my father. And, you know, he had passed away about 7 years ago now. And just the idea of letting go of basically the devastation that kind of happens to a person that loses someone so special, and how to kind of, I guess, find yourself, you know, because we are still alive and we're here. And that was one of those that just came instantly. Wow. The music, the melody, the lyrics. I remember I was writing that with Tim Pagnotta, who I guess one of his biggest hits was with Neon Trees in their first single. But he was just in the room, just, you know, it's like one of those things, you're just kind of thinking of ideas, 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 and then you just, you spark something, and it's just like, you're just jumping, you know, wall to wall. You're just, it's super exciting. So that was definitely, you know, one of the moments, you know, of creating this album.
Well, I couldn't be happier for you.
Thank you.
You're
so much.
Top 30, and then maybe next time we talk, top 10?
Oh,
is that a deal?
It's a deal.
By the record.
By the record.